Greetings, YouTube. I had hoped by this point of the year that I would have processed the November election of 2016. That I would have passed it through the mental network in my head that would put it into perspective. But I haven't. And I'm still angry. And it's manifesting itself as anger that is sometimes misdirected. I'm angry at traffic. I'm angry at devices that don't work. I'm angry at construction. Oh boy, am I angry at construction. My city is being torn apart by construction at the moment. You can't drive anywhere without hitting it. And I am, of course, of angry at the news I hear on the radio and I read and hear on the internet and I listen to people discuss in person. I have found a slight respite from the news on the radio. Whenever I encounter something that I find particularly egregiously angering, I'll just flick over to a classic station that I have access to. In fact, I've set up my radio up in the car, so I just have to flick a little switch with my thumb, and it goes from NPR to the classical station in one button, a push of a button. And bink, I am now listening to strings or pianos, or even occasionally harpsichord, which I preferred piano. And then after I've calmed down a bit, I'll go back to the radio. And anytime the president speaks, I move away from that immediately. I don't want to listen to anything the man has to say. I don't want to read his tweets. I don't want to listen to him. I don't want to look at pictures of him. I want nothing to do with him. There are two words I want the man to say, two words that I'm eager to hear. I resign. Until I hear those two words, I don't want to listen to anything the man has to say. Because as much as I despise everything about the guy, he's just a symptom of the disease in America. The disease that put him in office, a failed businessman, a failed father, a failed husband. A man that's failed his way up the ladder of success. A man that lost money running casinos. A reality TV star. But he's just the symptom of the disease. And that's what I'm angry about the most. It isn't just that my country is deeply white supremacist, deeply bigoted, horribly homophobic and transphobic and misogynistic. It loathes women. I'm angry about all those things. What I'm angry about the most is me. Because I was willing to ignore so much of it for so long because I thought that we were on an arc towards progress and we weren't. That my white privilege blinded me to what was going on in the world around me. As much as I thought I was aware, as much as I thought I was paying attention to the pulse of American politics and sociology, I wasn't. I failed my fellow citizens. I failed myself because I was willing to ignore so much because it was so easy. So that's where my real anger lies. And all those other things I mentioned are angering. And if you aren't angry, then you aren't paying attention. And if you're happy about any of these things, then I don't want you on my channel. I don't want to listen to your words any more than I want to listen to the orange clown in the White House. I ignored it for a long time. I'm not ignoring it anymore.